Welcome to the Kinematics Motion Performance Test Tutorial. Today I'm going to be going over exactly how to set up the performance test, what you're going to be looking for, and then once you collect the data, how you're going to use that data to make your graphs and to make a velocity time graphs. So let's get started. I'm going to start off the discussion about the setup, and more specifically, the camera setup. So perspective is very important. So first off, you want to use a phone that has Coach My Video, that would be for the iPhone, or Coach's Eye, which will be for the Android. You want to stand at the top of the stadium and in the center of your runner's run. So you can see here, the center of the runner's run is right here at the 30. So I was standing right about there, and I can mark that like so. You want to make sure that you yell go, so that way the runner can hear you and make sure that everybody's on the same page. Start your camera before you yell go. That way you get a little bit before the runner runs, and you get everything all the way through to the run. And you see here, he starts at the 10 and goes all the way to the 50. The runner needs to make sure that they know where their starting point is. In this case, he was starting at the 10, and where the finishing point, in this case, it was the 50, which includes 40 yards. So make sure that the runner knows where 40 yards is, where his start and his finish is. Make sure that they are lined up with the cameraman, which is, if the cameraman is here, that they are lined up at the 30. So therefore, 30 is halfway between 10 and 50. You need to run over the yard line marks. So you see here, the runner is running over these yard line marks. He's not running over here in the middle of the field or over there, but right over the yard line marks. So that way it's easy to tell where he is and when he is. And then also, listen for the cameraman to yell go, because the last thing you want to have to do is to do it over again because you didn't coordinate the time with your cameraman. So you started running before the camera started rolling, you're going to have to do it over again. You have to get that first time when he starts all the way through to the last time when he finishes. So this was the data that was collected after analyzing the run using Coach My Video. 1.1, 2.2, 3.0, 3.6, 4.2, 4.7, 5.3, 5.9, and 6.4. This gave a total of, if I take my 1.1 and my 6.4, 6.4 minus 1.1 is going to give me 5.3 seconds. These two numbers, 40 yards and 5.3 seconds, are going to be used later on whenever we start answering the questions. Now let's look at how to take this data that we just collected right here and put it onto a graph like this. So understand that the time is going to be on your x-axis and that the yard lines will be on the y-axis. So the first thing we got to do is we got to scale and label our x-axis, scale and label our y-axis. If we went through and counted how many grid lines we have going across, we'd find that the number of grid lines we have going across here is 20 grids. And also, if we look at our data, we need to go from 1.1 to 6.4. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 20 and divide it by 7, because I want to go just a little bit more than what my data has. Not too much more, but just a little bit. That's going to give me a little bit less than 3, or about 2.9. So what I'm going to round that up, and I'm going to make every third grid a second. So here's what that looks like. So if you see here, we've got 1, 2, 3, and that is where I'm going to put my first mark. So there's my first mark. And I go 1, 2, 3, put my second mark. 1, 2, 3, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and that's all I really need to do. Now I just put my numbers. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So the last thing I got to do is I got to put my label on. So I'm going to have to make some adjustments to do that. So I'm just going to move this up just a little bit so that way I can put my label at the bottom. And I'm going to call this time. And time is measured in seconds. Now, the same thing I need to do to the y-axis. So, notice it goes from 0 to 40. And again, I have 20 grid lines going all the way up. And that comes out to be a very easy transition. So basically what it's going to say is every mark is 2. So this is 2, this is 4, this is 6, this is 8, and this will be 10. So I'm going to mark every 10 yards, where every 10 yards is, and every 10 yards will be on every 5th yard line mark, or 5th grid line mark. So that's going to look something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then that's going to be for 10. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 20. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 30. And then finally, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this will be for 40. And now I still have to label what I've done for the y-axis. And I'm just going to move this over this way so that way you can see, or I can write down, have enough room to write down position. And position is going to be labeled as yards. Now that we have scaled, and labeled our graph, it's time to take the data that we have here and put it onto a graphical form. So we'll start out with the time and the yard line mark. So the time is 1.1, so 1.1 is just inside of 1, and the yard line mark is 0. So here's 0, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a dot. So there's our first mark. Our second mark will be right here. Our third mark, based on that it's at 3 seconds and 10 yards, will be right here. After that comes 3.6 at 15 yards. So 3.6 is going to be just inside of this line. And we're going to go up to 15, and 15 is going to be right about there. So I'm going to put a mark right there. After that, we got 4.2 and 20. So 4.2 is going to be right in here, and then 20 is right here. So we go to where those two lines match up, which will be right there. Moving along, we have our next one, which is 4.7 and 25. So 4.7 is going to be just outside of this line, and 25 will be halfway between, so it's going to be right about there. All right, so our next one, after 4.7 comes 5.3 at 30. So let's find that here. 5.3, which is right here, and we go all the way up to 30, which is on this line, so it comes in just a little bit inside right there. And our next one is going to be 5.9 all the way up to 35. So 5.9 is just under 6. We take that line all the way up. We keep going. And look at that. We are right there at 35. So let's put a mark right there. And the last one that we're going to do is going to be the time at 6.4. 6.4 is almost way over here at the end, all the way up to 40. And here's the 40-yard line. And so this is where we will put our last and final dot. Okay, now that we have done it all, we're going to find out where our straight edge is going to be and where is our curve. Okay, so our curve is probably going to be right about here, and then this is where we'll need to have our straight edge. So let's get that straight edge out there. All right, so here is our line, and what we're going to do with this line is we're going to line it up and see where it lines up with our data and where it doesn't. So you can see here that as I line it up here, it lines up with this dot, that dot, that dot, that dot, all the way up here. And it lines up very nicely. However, it does not line up with these two because this is where it curves away. So what happens? What's happening at that curve? Anybody know? Well, if you thought that it might be accelerating there, you'd be right. So let's go ahead and put the line where it's supposed to be. And so I'm going to move the line. And so it stops right about here. And I'm going to include a curve for the next line. And there's our curve. So we have acceleration, which is where we have our curve. And then we have a constant velocity through the rest of the 40 yards. We're going to come back to this graph for some analysis later on.